So welcome back, everybody. Welcome, welcome, welcome to the Elder Scrolls.
Okay!
Someone's excited. Are you okay there, Dragon? Can you even hear what I am saying, Dragon? Or have you just left your microphone on again? Did you leave your microphone on again, Dragon? I'm gonna have to put you in the shame corner, if that's the truth. I think he left his microphone on. I'm gonna put him in the shame corner. We have Digi who falls asleep during the broadcast, and we have Dragon who just... Into the shame corner you go! Into the shame corner you go. Into the corner of shame. Anyway, everybody, welcome back to the Elder Scrolls Skyrim. So, I've been doing a lot of stuff behind the scenes. I've uploaded some files for those of you who are interested in it and become a Patreon supporter and get access to all my work in progress files. But, all that said, I've actually finally gotten the spectral boots to work. Yes, that's right. I don't need my spectral potion anymore. But I've got my spectral boots working. Now, ideally what I wanted to do is just be spectral on the boots, but as you can see, it's not doing that. But, wait, not that one. It's actually an enchantment, so you can actually pull the enchantment off and put it on other things. So I'm still tinkering with it, but I've actually got the visuals working. And actually, it has an enchantment effect. So actually, if I go to... Active effects? It does a number of things. Spectral hide boots, right there. Increase magic resistance by 2%, increase frost resistance by 11%, whereas muffled and move silently, take on the traits of a ghost. So it does a few things. Yes, Voivus, I am streaming Skyrim. And let me tell you, actually getting it to work like this was kind of tricky, because when I first did it, I apparently left one setting in a way I really shouldn't have, which meant that once I put the spectral boots on, even if I took them off, I was still transparent. What the heck? What's attacking? Who's attacking? Where's attacking? Why am I getting combat music? Okay, that was weird. That was very weird. Alright. So we actually need to make it where? That's right, we need to make it actually up to Ingle Barrel. And that's to the east. Bodyguard, bodyguard. Pelagio, interesting. Oh, a bandit attacked. Interesting. The heck? I have not seen the channel description for the Shame Corner. Remember your orders. Avoid any fight unless it's inevitable. We need of your group here. Interesting.
Hi.
Hello. Out of the Shame Corner.
I'm back. I'm on another register. Also, Nikolai, do you think tonight we could do a Tokusatsu movie?
What movie are you thinking?
Ghost movie, maybe? And the Allen, I think. The Allen show, I think, came out.
You're thinking the 100 Icons?
Yeah, the one on the summer movie. Because, like, I know you're moving this weekend.
Yeah. Yeah, I suppose we can do the 100 Icon movie.
Mm-hmm. Or we could do the Mach and Heart movie ago.
Probably should do Mach and Heart since we never managed to do it the last time and we keep putting it off. We're going to keep forgetting that we haven't done it.
Mm-hmm.
We should probably do that.
We did Chaser, but we never done Heart and Mach. I don't know how long those movies go.
And I'm dead.
Have an emergency. Hmm?
And I've died. Apparently there was an evil mage and he fireballed me to death before I could really react. Not even like 7 minutes into the stream and half of that was just making sure everything was set up and I get killed. And I am way far back.
Is Garo very trippy?
At times, a Garo can be trippy.
I'm gonna be busy tomorrow. I'm doing karaoke. So what are you doing? Like, you're playing Skyrim?
Mm-hmm.
Or the Rims of Sky? I'm actually gonna go watch a few movies first, because I want to get myself get down. Okay, so there's a Kamen Rider Ghost movie, Alan, and then there's an epilogue Hyper Battle video. Do you want to risk those as well as the Alan 1-4 and F5 Hyper Battle video as well with the Ghost movie?
We should probably just do Heart because we keep skipping it, and honestly, Heart itself is going to be pretty lengthy. I mean, it's a full length movie, isn't it, or is it a half an hour one?
Yeah, it's like an hour and 30 minutes.
So yeah, we'll probably just do that because anything else would be way too much for Morphin Monday.
Unless we could do an Allen, which I think should be only about...
But we really should do Heart, because we keep putting it off.
Mm-hmm. Heart first.
Yes, Heart.
And if we have time, we should probably do something to finish the night off to fit the 2 hour range, you know what I mean?
Well, I mean, technically, Morphin Monday is only half an hour. Because all we ever do on Morphin Monday is a single episode of Power Rangers.
Well, true, but then again, this could be the replacement for next week. You know what I mean?
Useless. I'm useless.
And I'll watch the stream for you tomorrow.
Oh,
or like
hello
the
didn't notice you come
while
up.
You're gone, while you're moving.
I was focusing my magic. Or at least I thought I was. I don't really know what I'm doing.
That's quite a staff you have there, aspiring mage.
So too. See, my grandfather was a wizard. My father wouldn't talk about it much. I found some
will
of his things in the
will you be going through Texas
attic,
on your way to Delaware,
staff.
Or, not Delaware,
after
but,
that, I thought I was
I don't think we're going to be going through Texas now.
Because dead things near me would come to life again for a while. I even went to the College of Winterhold. They just laughed at me. The magic is in the staff, not in me, they said.
Just give me the staff before somebody gets hurt, you stupid aspiring mage.
Okay, okay. You've talked me into it. In fact, keep it. I must have used up the magic in the staff or something. It's just a dumb stick of wood now.
That was a weird animating glitch. What staff did I get from this idiotic mage? It's a staff of reanimation, a staff of zombies. And he's apparently so incompetent, he doesn't know how to use a magic staff because it's got a full charge on it. That's a level of idiocracy that I don't know how many other people have.
Poor Takaharu. Because he's always on fire all the fucking time, so no one shut up.
I think I've actually fixed the problem for a bit, so actually the more people that you add while I'm, well, I suppose, yeah, while I'm online it works best, but the more people that you can actually add, the more I can actually test to make sure I've fixed all the bugs. I think I have fixed all of the bugs that were causing the bot to crash. You know how it is with bug testing? Of course you know how it is with bug testing, is that you think you've fixed everything and then there's some other variable that you've missed. But I think I've caught all of the variables that have been throwing exceptions. Who the heck are you? You're a vigilant of Stendar, aren't you?
Stendar's mercy be upon you, for the vigil has none to spare. You speak to a vigilant of Stendar. Cavort with any Daedra, and we will hunt you down.
You hunt Daedra?
Any other abominations that prey on mortals. Vampires, werewolves, witches.
What about ghosts?
But the Daedra are the worst. Their callous disregard for
all. What about ghosts?
In the eyes of the God of Mercy.
What about Doki Doki Ghost? I was trying to get a ghost down.
Vigil will be watching.
Gonna outrun a deer. Okay. More dead bandits. On the plus side, there's no longer a toll on the road. Quick save. I actually gotta make it north to Windhelm. Something just froze. Looks like Skyrim crashed. Let's try it again.
If somebody dunk him. Yeah, I'm gonna mute my mic.
Alrighty. All my monitors are acting weird now. No, I haven't watched Mask Racer Rex episode 3 yet, Phlebas. I think I might be stuck in the geometry. Alright, so we need to head north. Actually, how do I get north? From here. I could, I suppose, just keep heading east, theoretically. Iron, okay. I'm here, Furbus. Can you not hear me? My microphone's working. Yeah, everything seems to be working. Overgrown temple discovered. That I can explore. Oh yeah, there is. What? That's not disturbing at all. Search the offering chest. Interesting. This must be one of the hidden hideaways. Yeah, interesting. Yeah, because this is kind of small, isn't it? I do like the design, though. Open to Skyrim. Huh, interesting. Interesting. One of the hidden hideaways. The hidden hideaways are mod. Now, how do I get back out? Anything else interesting? Around here, doesn't look like it. And we're being attacked. Of course we are. I don't have the magicka. Of course I don't. One hand. Yes. Haha! How do you like my fist now? Silver sword. That's not bad.
Still trying to... For some damn reason,
why am I getting these weird animation bugs? I'll have to look into that.
Wait, what's in your mod?
Oh, I have a few different mods. One that overhauls guards, one that overhauls female armor. I have one that just adds name tags to various items added by other mods. But something is doing something weird with the animations. We're getting a lot of T-posing, which is weird. I actually uploaded all the mods that I'm working on to my Patreon server for anyone who wants to try mods that are works in progress or updates to existing mods that I'm not ready to release an update for. At the bandit camp. I cannot conjure an Atronach. Why are you punching? Oh, that's because I never gave you any weapons, did I? I took away all of your weapons, Janasa. Of course I did. That's why you have no weapons to attack with. Let me give you some weapons, Shinasa.
What can I do for you, friend? I'll be sure to put it to good use.
I'll give you 2 silver swords, because why not? And I will give you hunting bow, and how about 79 fulmer arrows? There, now you should have more than enough stuff to work with.
Lead on.
I said I have not seen episode 3 of Rex. What up here?
Also, Nikolai, I might need your help later. I need your help on cutting down the body of not. For like 30 minutes long, and I just need to for the performance part.
Still one shot in wolves.
Who's in the chat, Nikolai?
I can't see the exact names at the moment because, of course, I'm streaming, so I can't check the Twitch log. Find Electric Drummer, Chardax, Salbathar, and Alftan. Why do I have the feeling that those two are in Solstheim? Why else would it not be able to show it to me on the map? Why do you keep asking me the same question, Furbus? Can you not hear me in the voice chat?
Wait, is Furbus talking on the voice chat?
He keeps typing into the text channel.
Oh.
Oh my god, this thing is tough. My god, this thing is massive. I may die to a giant wolf. I'm gonna get out some ice, some fire spells. My god, these things are massive.
Have you ever tried chocolate peanut butter?
Yes, a number of times.
How is it?
Get them, my undead minions! Get them, my undead minions! Aha! Can you get me now? Stupid dogs. Can you get me now? They are absolutely destroying my team, though. Ice wargs are nothing to mess with. Oh, the Ice Warg's dead. Ice Wolf is dead. That should look like most. Yeesh. Nice work, Janasa. I think we lost most of our undead army, but she survived. Still heading in the completely wrong direction. We need to actually head more east. Can I summon an Atronach? No, I can't summon an Atronach. What about Firebolt? And I'm gonna get my ass kicked by a bear!
Kill it!
I am trying to! Let's see what's inside the bronze water cave. More bears. Why am I getting the "you have discovered something special" sound? And the Mission Impossible music. Not bad. There has to be something in here. I'm just not saying it. Yeah, I don't see any indication anywhere of anything interesting. Testing 1, 2, 3. All my mics are reporting the right volumes.
Can you hear me?
I can hear you just fine.
I know.
I think Ferbus might have either put one or both of us on a very low volume.
Yeah. You can turn it up on the bottom left corner.
Very weird little cave we have discovered.
You gonna raid it?
There really wasn't anything to raid. There was a couple of bears to kill. That's about it.
Mm-hmm. Never know, you might find some gold or something.
I found a little bit of gold. In fact, I found some boots with a stealth enchantment. Which, considering I have a ring of stealth that I didn't want to break down, I can now break down those boots. And we've got more danger. Eat my Atronachia, Ice Ray. Maybe I'll punch the Ice Wraith instead. That worked a lot more effectively than using magic. Way more effectively than using magic.
Okay, I'm gonna restart my computer. Hopefully my computer will start working and I'll be able to download the file for tonight.
Alrighty.
We might have to do it later, do the actual show later. I want to review the movie first.
Right.
And review it, and then I can rift it with you once I get my material ready. You know what I mean?
Right.
So.
Save, just to be sure. Uh-oh. Don't fall off the mountain. That is not a good plan. are we heading now? On course. Where is the shrine?
In the mountains to the northeast. I'll mark it on your map.
If it's to the north, well, I mean, technically we are on the east side. I suppose it could be trying to find a way around the mountain.
Could you, parachute off the mountain?
Nope. This is not Zelda.
When you play Zelda, is that somebody actually sent you the switch and whatnot?
Oh crap, another ice wolf.
Okay, go off the line, I'll be back in a few. Oh, it'll take a while, but...
Probably has his mic turned off. Wonder if he has his speakers turned down. Quick save. Twitch, let me unmute stuff. And now let me actually mute stuff, Twitch, because sheesh. Twitch can be finicky. Windhelm Stables. Is there anything? Why is there a little house icon? I did not watch Rex episode 3, Phlebas. Why is there a little house icon? What the heck am I being told about? Whoa. And I died. Fell off of a bridge and died. Somehow that seems fitting. Saw some little icon on my map, followed it, and ran over off a bridge. Alright. Let's try this again without the dying. What the heck is this? Okay. This is kind of neat. Oh, it's got to be all the stuff that's in the docks, isn't it? Interesting.
Hey.
Hey, Furbus. That snow looks weird with the lighting. Black snow in Skyrim.
I'm in Winford snow night. Oh boy, snow.
At least we've made it over to Windhelm. We have two little locations to explore in this area. But, you know, now to think about it, joining the Stormcloaks might not be a bad idea. Considering, you know, the Imperials threw me into a prison that was flooded and left me to die. Not exactly a big fan of the Imperials.
Yes?
Just a little house up in the middle of nowhere. What do we have here? Should I really investigate a place called Traitor's? Oh boy. It's overrun by bandits. Of course it's overrun by bandits. We'll find out soon. Oh, they're definitely not Gerudo. And nope, I do not have enough magicka. To cast some magic spells on them, so I'm gonna have to punch them in the face. Ooh, nice kill cam. Just backbreaker. The unarmed kill cams in this game are actually kind of fun. Hello, bandit. Yes, let's hide inside the barrel. No, I can actually lock the barrel. I'm not sure if I really need to lock the barrel, though. That does not seem like a priority worth prioritizing. Probably don't need to lock the dresser either. Ooh. Another traitor map. Actually, did I even look at the traitor map I got from Lucky? I don't think I ever did. Yeah, it doesn't look like I did. I'll have to take a look at it again, because I know that until you actually look at the treasure map, the treasures don't spawn. I don't think I ever looked at Lucky's treasure map. Ah yes, Tamriel Online. That is an interesting mod, but it is always been kind of finicky, hasn't it? You're basically trying to add online functionality to a game that's designed for, well, offline. So, I'm not surprised that you're having trouble getting Tamriel Online working, Penstroke. The burrow we need to go to is right over there. Another ice wraith? Seriously? These things are always so damn hard to see. Where did the ice wraith die? Ooh. Oh, it's in the air. The ice wraith is in the air. Yeah, I'd be surprised if you could do any of the main storyline with Tamriel Online. It's just so finicky. Hi, Mike. There's Mike the Liar. And actually, where do I need to go? I just passed Ingle Barrow. So that is actually over here? How the heck did Uthbark lose his necklace all the way over here? That's what I want to know. Punching skeletons. Like a balls. Where are you, skeleton? Well, into Ingle's Barrow. That is very weird. Really? That's what you're going to talk about, Janasa? The Nordic ruins. How they're old and secret, as opposed to the glowing ball that just bounced towards us. This is a little eerie. Not sure if I trust the glowing green orbs. Now, we want to check out the notes on Ingle Barrow. What a peculiar place this Barrow turned out to be. I hadn't explored for very long before reaching this elaborate room and gate locking me from going further into the crypt. I confess it. I'm relieved. This place puts the fear of oblivion into me. There are some carvings in this room. I'll attempt to transcribe them for the college, so I have something to show for their effort. All was so in Atmora, land of truth and our home. Man in his throne, so should he be. Whale in the sea, so should he be. Eagle in the sun sky, so should he be. Snake in the weed, so should he be. Sorrow! For the sea ghost took Ingle, prize brother of sail, from Atmora's fleet, and none on land, nor sky, nor sea, would ever again be as should be. Fascinating. These ancient Norse. Wonder what other secrets are hidden here. True, they can't be harmed in trying to go a little further. And there's a lever here, which must open the gate beyond. Yes, obviously the lever will open the gate beyond, but did you think that maybe, just maybe, with all the little turning pedestals, that there's some sort of, you know, trap? This thing ever gonna stop? It just keeps going, doesn't it? I actually had to turn it off. That was not possibly my best. Okay, I gotta sit on the throne. You know I have to. Alright, so this is water, so whale in the water. Snake in the grass. And eagle into the sky. I'm not sure if I trust these balls. I'll take the coral dragon claw. Nope. I haven't mentioned this before, but in this particular Let's Play, we're respecting the dead. We're not just gonna loot crypts. We're not gonna loot the urns and whatnot. If something's sitting on a shelf, we'll grab that, but we're not looting urns and whatnot. We actually respect the dead in this playthrough. Treasure chests, on the other hand, I will loot them. I didn't add any new mods for this playthrough, but there's definitely a couple things I want to add now that we're going through here. So far, it's the water-breathing, breathless emerge tweak. And armor of Ingle. And actually, magic glows would be good as well. Magic emits light, basically. I'm not sure if I trust these balls of light, though. Yeah, sure, I'll grab the hanging moss. Why not? Where are all of the undead monstrosities that fill these things? This place is too quiet. I do not feel comfortable in a place this quiet. Take the hide boots. I won't loot the burial urn. Oh, right. One of the mods I installed previously is Subtle Traps, or maybe I haven't actually made a note of that, but yeah, that's a pressure plate. You don't notice them anymore because they're more subtle. My god, that thing's gonna be impossible to move past, isn't it? Shanasa, please don't set off the trap trigger! Well, that's a fun little painting, isn't it? So, all signs point to speeders up ahead. Miscellaneous, we're looking for Coral Dragon Claw. Snake, Wolf, Butterfly. And yes, you can see I have a Dragon Claw retexture. Snake, Wolf, Butterfly, okay. That is a lot of little spirit orbs. A little disturbing. Especially since they all seem to want to get in here. What are you all gonna do once the door is fully open? I'm gonna give myself some defenses. There you go, Janasa. You've got oak flesh, I've got oak flesh. Can't summon an Atronach now, can I? I'll put on my Spectral Boots. They're a little bit better defense than what I have now. Nope, can't summon my Atronach just yet. Apprentice Flames, yes. Do I have... I do. Crap! Crap, 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 maybe upgrade to the firebolts. Just distract him a little longer, Janessa. I just need one more good shot at him, Janessa. Whew. Good boy. Well, there's Uthbergs. Necklace. Elven sword. That's actually not bad. I definitely have to reinstall the mod, the Armor of Ingle. That is a very cool mod. I guess I'll show it to you guys next time. I believe it's actually only an old Rim mod, so I'd actually have to convert it. But that's fine. I can convert mods just fine. That is not a tricky process. Well, it can be tricky depending on what you're converting, but for the most part, most old Rim mods can be converted pretty painlessly. I'm reminded suddenly of a quest that I heard about but never actually installed. There is a quest mod, I don't know if it's been converted to SSE, but basically what it did is it gave you a purpose for collecting all the dragon claws. Because then there was this like master dungeon where you needed all of the dragon claws, yes, even the golden one, to get in. And I think I'd like to give that one a shot. Is that a word wall over there? Yeah, I suppose it won't hurt to check it out. It looks like the back of a word wall. But I don't think it is, actually. No, it's just a mountain. The weirdest feeling is there's supposed to be a word wall around here, but I am not seeing hide nor hear of it. Yeah, I think I can give a different borrow. Oh, go ahead. Tell me why you prefer Uldrim. Because I will always prefer new Skyrim. Because 64-bit means such a difference. You guys have no idea just how big going 64-bit really means. I did a video on it, and it is pretty big. I'm going to go and summon an Atronach first off. Well, for the most part, the mods issue is a non-issue because it is really easy to convert mods. So, at least for me, that doesn't really mean much because I can convert mods like that. When I did my first playthrough, I converted a ton of mods. Then my hard drive died, so I'm just like, yeah, whatever. I'll start over. And honestly, my PC runs new Skyrim much better, but I'm also running a 64-bit OS. You're really going to see the benefit of new Skyrim if you've got a 64-bit OS with, you know, at least 8 gigabytes of RAM. Because the 32-bit game that was original Skyrim, its max cap was 4 gigabytes, and that includes your RAM from your video card. So if you don't have a very powerful computer, you know, old RAM is not going to be that big of a difference, but trust me, if you're running a 64-bit OS and you've got a decent amount of RAM, the new Skyrim is going to run so much buttery smoother. And it can handle your computer, upgrading your computer a lot better. Because remember, old RAM's 32-bit. So it's maximum capacity for RAM, including video memory. So memory inside the computer and memory from your video card maxes out at 4 gigabytes. For new Skyrim, well, it's based upon your operating system, but the low end, I believe, is 64 gigabytes, again, limited by your OS. The upper limit is 128, again, limited by your OS. But the actual hardware limit of a 64-bit OS is 4 exabytes, which is... Let's put things in perspective. All right, so you know that 1,024 megabytes makes a gigabyte. 1,024 gigabytes makes a terabyte. 1,024 terabytes makes a petabyte. 1,024 petabytes makes a nanobyte. And 1,024 nanobytes makes 1 exabyte. And a 64-bit OS can handle 4 exabytes. So, yeah. That's a lot of memory. I do not want to have to swim across there. And now we're not running Frostfall, but we're playing by Frostfall rules. And water like that is not something you want to swim in. I do find it kind of annoying that Uldrim has become the name. I always preferred Skyrim Classic. But Uldrim just become the name that people use. It's kind of sad. Oh yeah, if you've got 4 exabytes with an E, EXA, exabytes, you're probably working for NASA. That's true, but the fact that you have that potential, it says a lot. And hell, I'm pretty sure most people with a 64-bit computer are probably running with, what, 16 to 32 gigabytes of RAM? That's pretty average. Some might max out what's currently being, you know, promoted with 128, but the idea is with 64-bit is at the upper limit we haven't actually reached. The 64-bit OS is so powerful. Ugh, we're swimming through frigid waters. It's a good thing I have a fur coat, because the idea with the 64-bit OS is that it's just so advanced that it's going to take decades for hardware to catch up to the software limitations for the 64-bit OS. That's kind of the thing. Unlike the old thing where, you know, Bill Gates said that no one's going to ever need more than, what, 16 megabytes of storage? By the time we can actually take full advantage of a 64-bit OS, the sun will probably explode. Because think about just how much is going to have to happen in the tech industry for a commercial computer to support 4 exabytes of RAM. It's kind of insane, considering we're still sitting at around 128 is the standard. 128 gigabytes. We haven't even hit terabytes of memory yet. It's going to be a while before we hit exabytes of memory. I have leveled up. I'm going to throw some points into stamina because I've been neglecting it. What can I get an illusion to work with? Apprentice illusions. Kindred mage. No. Quiet casting. Ah. Can't get anything in conjuration. I could do destruction dual casting, or I could do augmented flames. Restoration, maybe. I could do... You know, that's not a bad one to do, considering we are doing a mage build. Magic and recovering faster isn't bad. Have I seriously put no points into alteration, despite the fact that I have alteration spells? Alright, that's a given. Does that allow me to do oak flesh so much easier? Okay, how much is oak flesh going to cost me now? 41. That's actually not that bad. There you go, Janasa. Oak flesh other. I'm gonna go with Apprentice Flames. That's one of my new spells that I created, along with Oak Flesh Other. I've actually created Flames up to Master level. Ugh. Is the night vision even gonna work for me? I don't think so. Fire Rune. In case anyone decides to come and give us a visit. Sheath your weapons before hiding. I can do that. No one ever suspects the bucket. See? No one ever suspects the bucket. Ever. No one ever suspects the bucket. The barrel of laughs. Yes, move on. There's nothing here but us barrels. Go ahead. Return to your previous business. Yeah. No one suspects the barrel.
No one ever suspects the barrel.
Ever. It may not be a cardboard box, but it's close enough. I am so cramped from sticking into that barrel. Anything else of interest over here? I'll take the lockpick. Ooh, a surfeit of thieves. Lockpicking increased to 29. I'll take that. Instantly break a lockpick. And then get it on the second pick. Ooh.
Hey, what's the sneak music? What's the sneak music this time?
It's Mission Impossible rock version. Nice work there, Janasa.
You're doing a great job, Janasa.
She is a great companion.
That's what says you're off on.
Who says you can't trust a dark elf?
I've never heard anyone say that.
Well, you know, Windhelm, they say it all the time. But of course, we all know that Windhelm is full of a bunch of bigots. They don't even like Khajiit, I bet.
Shame. I'm coming. Come on.
So I still got something over here to find, but is there anything else I need to focus on and find over here? I think though that I found everything here on the upper level. Hey. We got over here. Yeah, sure. Yeah. And then I've completed all the books I need to find. I have to return them to Windle area. Who is located where? Riften, yep, thought so. Bring the books to Windle area. Ugh. Deliver the necklace to Uthbart, collect a bounty from Anders. Yes, our next goal really should be Winterhold. So we can do the Blood Dwemer Cube at Aftand. Get the Mythos from Serana. Then after that, really, what do we have left to do? I guess all the stuff on this side of the map. But then we'll be done with all of our notice board quests. We'll have to figure out what we're going to do then. Necromancers can be fun, especially if you've got my mod that overhauls the Ritual Stone. You can just spam the Ritual Stone, and then you can literally have an undead army. That's fun for a Necromancer build. But honestly, a Huntress is pretty much the same as a Stealth Archer, and that's kind of boring. So if you're going to do a Huntress, you know, you're going to end up playing the safe route, which is the Stealth Hunter. Which is not the most interesting of... Good boy. We are a swimming Khajiit in frozen water. Journal Advald. I can't believe I let Skelger talk me into this again. If he just wanted to get a drink and swap stories, we could have done that in front of a nice fire back in Windhelm, instead of on this godforsaken mudflat. But the fish are biting, Edvar! The catch will be more pay for the trip! Yeah, right. If we don't get iced in first, his boat's already taken on water. I guess we'll try again tomorrow. If we don't catch something then, I'm heading home, with or without him. I'm guessing things did not go well. Who are you shooting at, Janasa? Seriously, who are you shooting at, Janasa? I don't see anyone. Well, as I said before, I believe necromancy would be more... Janasa's fighting a fish. Janasa has declared war on a fish. Legavana! Where did you come from? heck is anything interesting here? Alright. Moving back along to our goal. That could work. Barbarian Necromancer is a fun concept. Crap! There is a bear trying to kill me! Oh yeah, so Lich Mod, that's a fun mod.
What does that do?
Allows you to become an undead Lich.
Ooh.
And it's another bear. I'm going to hit this bear with a firebolt. I'm being attacked by a warg as well as a bear. Of course I am.
Of course.
Crap! I'm dead.
That's how many of us done so far this stream?
I think only three.
I think so.
Oak Flesh. Atronach. Wonderful. Being attacked by multiple wargs now. Crap! See? Dead again. You know, the funny thing is that technically, since I haven't even fought the first dragon, or, you know, even been to Helgen, I don't know if that's true, because I don't know if I'm technically the Dragonborn. I haven't been to Helgen yet. I don't know if technically that bandit's doomed anyone or not at this point. And here come the wargs. You can't win, wargs! I have the high ground! Get back to the high ground. There are a lot of wargs. And there's more coming. As long as my magic I can regenerate, I should be fine.
Should. Should is the main word.
Are they running away from me or leading me into a trap?
I'd say a little bit of both. They're both running away and leading me into a trap. They just don't know it.
There are way too many puppies in this area.
And that's a bad thing, Hal.
Well, I'm a cat, for one thing. Abandoned camp discovered. A random horse in the middle of nowhere. Bunch of dead workers. Interesting. On the plus side, if I get attacked here, I can stand on a table and should be safe.
But then the table will fall.
Well, you know what? If the game's gonna give me a horse, I will take the horse. It's considered high ground to me.
If you ride that, you'll always have the high ground.
Nordic Plateau discovered. I just killed my horse.
Good job.
And apparently I died with it. Wow. That horse took a nasty fall and took me with it. Oh my, oh my, oh my.
Next horse you get, you gotta name him High Ground. Gotta name him the High Ground.
I am not afraid of the Horker. I'm going to ignore the Horker. Now, where is that Nordic Plateau? Oh, it's over here. Okay. Now, what the heck is the Nordic Plateau?
Well, obviously, it's the Nordic Plateau. You knew better, Nicola.
This one's listed as Snowvale Sanctum, not Nordic Plateau. Interesting.
But it's not the Nordic Plateau.
That's weird. Did the horse flee? I think the horse abandoned me.
A high ground has escaped.
Alright, let's see here. Oh, the Nordic Plateau is here? Just separate from Snowvale Sanctum? Well, it happens to have the third Sky Shard I was looking for. I'm gonna consider that a win. Because that gives me a perk point. Oh, crap!
What happened?
I've got a bear trying to kill me.
Must be Tuesday. Looks like it must be Tuesday.
Hey, bear! Oh, the bear's running away. Okay.
You scared the bear?
The bear seems to be coming back. Eat fireballs! Oh, no. Crap!
You re-angered the bear.
I have angered the bear.
Not once. Twice.
Yes, that is very true. Nah, I've got the high ground there. You can't get to me here.
Are you sure it's not half billy goat, half bear?
Honestly, I wouldn't put it past the bear. You know what? I just got a perk point. You know it'd be incredibly useful right now. That restoration perk that makes my magicka regenerate faster.
It would.
Ha ha ha! Crud! The bear's still after me! Ah, the bear's dead now. And now there's a wolf after me.
Actually, we have a perk that can help get more IP. More IP that.
I think we do actually have a perk like that. I think all the things trying to kill me are dead now. For the moment.
Yeah, they'll never truly be dead. Yeah.
My goodness. Heal.
If you need someone to blame for all this happening, blame Deneb.
I do blame Deneb. Always Deneb's fault.
Don't worry, Deneb is right here. In my hands.
Yes, I'm going to lock the sack. The potato sack.
One no potato sack came across.
Alright. Oh, can't go into Snowville. Sanctum requires a key.
But do you have keys?
I do not have the key for Snowvale Sanctum.
Oh.
Alright. Back onward to Winterhold. Is there a mine up ahead? Why is there a mine icon up ahead? What mu- Where are you, Janasa?
I've been looking. Got something I'm supposed to deliver.
Okay, courier. Well, there's definitely a mine here. Whistling Iron Mine. Well, we might as well check it out. Lord knows, we've been swimming in that frigid water enough, we can find a nice fire to warm up by. It wouldn't be a bad idea. Oh, yes. Warm fire.
Are you feeling sick?
Well, I did just swim through a bunch of frigid water to fight bandits, so probably I'm a bit sick and big.
Starting to think we might not even find iron. We've been at it for so long.
Gunding.
Careful where you step in the mine. Don't want to cover up some valuable ore or gem. Something.
I'm not going to steal their coin purse. Is going on here in the Whistling Iron Mine? Well, they've definitely got iron ore. If I want to get iron ore, I can come here. Whew. At least nothing's trying to kill us. I'm gonna take that as a positive.
I think I'm gonna try and kill you soon.
Sounds like this. I wish there was a mod that allowed me to sit anywhere. That would, this would be definitely the perfect time for sitting. Sit mod. So I'll look for a sitting mod. I know there's Dovahkiin Relaxes, but I've never really liked Dovahkiin Relaxes. It's kind of random. Usually what I just want to do is certain emotes, not just random idles. Well, back onto the road.
Nope, sorry.
Looks like there's a ruin right over there. What could that be, though? Do I really want to investigate it? Journeyman's Nook, which sounds like it has some nasties ready to pick a fight. The bandit with a couple of fireballs. Loot everything he owns and slink through here into Bandit's Nook. What do we got into Bandit's Nook to explore? Apothecary satchel. A flute. Just a little nook, isn't it? Nothing terribly complicated in here. Ah, Journeyman's Nook has a treasure map. Oh, that's Vathim Tower. I know that location. We're gonna have to do a run where we just do looking for treasure. We've now got three treasure maps. You know what we need? We need a mod that actually adds some lights to Winterhold, because my god, Winterhold should be lit up at night. It's a mage's college, it should look magical.
Yeah.
Another abandoned camp. Interesting. Lots of little nooks and crannies. Ooh, what am I stand? Ori Halkum. Ooh. Well, definitely gonna have to do some pickaxing to the Ori Halkum vein. What am I being attacked by? An assassin, of course it is. Flame after knock, right there. And get oak flesh. Nice try, assassin. My claws are very powerful. Dark Brotherhood note. As instructed, you are to eliminate Katrina by any means necessary. The Black Sacrament has been performed. Somebody wants this poor fool dead. We've already received payment for the contract. Failure is not an option. Astrid. Janasa, I need you to carry some of my burdens.
What can I do for you? What do you need to take?
Actually, not too many burdens, to be honest. But I'll give her some burdens anyway. I'll give her all the burdens she can carry. You can even have the staff of reanimation, for all it's worth. Yeah, that should be good. Enough, I've got 300 carry weight free now. And she is completely maxed out. There's a Shrine of Azura, which we can probably get to. Doesn't look like it's too far off. It is a long hour route. Yeah, it looks like we'll be having no trouble getting up to the Shrine of a Bear! Atronach. Wow, he just one-shotted my Atronach. And it's a wolf. And there's the bear! Janasa. Be careful there, Janasa. Whew, the bear's dead.
Yeah.
Janasa has been my best friend since I picked her up. She has saved my life so many times. I have no problem healing her ass. Alright, now, Shrine of Azura. How do we get up to that? Pretty much facing it, okay. We're not going to be able to get up there. We have to go around the long way, don't we? The cave of some sort. It leads to where? What nasty critters are gonna try and kill me if I decide to investigate this cave? Oh gosh, another bear. Well, there's no point in even attempting to resurrect, to bring in a Atronach! Heal! Oh great, it's a sightless pit. Disagree, Janasa. I think that bear put up a pretty damn good fight. I'm not sure why you considered it cowardly. It was kicking both of our asses. Huh. Yes, let's jump into the pit. Yeah, I'm not jumping into a pit. Because the chances are I'm not going to find a way out. Now, come on, let me get up here. Crap. To abandon cave? What's in this abandoned cave? I doubt it actually is abandoned. Okay. This is eerily peaceful. Can't use that door. Could only open from the... Oh. The door is barred from the other side. Okay. Okay, considering its proximity to the sightless pit, I'm guessing the sightless pit's exit is through there. I just cannot get to this little point of interest. Maybe up here. A ritual site. This is gonna be... Yeah, it's just straight up called ritual site. Yeah, skeleton, I am not falling for that. Elven shield, though. That's not bad. Now, we are definitely off course. Let's try and get actually back to Windhelm, because I think we should call the stream don't go into the abandoned cave. Should probably call the stream here for today. And if we can get to Windhelm, I can take a carriage back to Whiterun for all my selling, plus do selling there, and see if there's anything we can do to help them out there. Because now that we've got a major city, I should be able to just take a carriage between the two and pick up next time when we do our little exploration of a Dwemer ruin. So let us see. We need to go this way, it looks like. Plus maybe I can find a nice mod to make Winterhold look a bit nicer. I am not feeling comfortable with all these billy goats around. You know what happens when you got billy goats. Where there's billy goats, there's trolls. Is this the center of Winterhold? I think we're about to enter Winterhold. Mm. Let me put on my Amulet of Dibella. So I'm a little bit more speech crafty.
You and me can flow. Going to college and prance about casting spells all day.
Hey, nothing wrong with spells. I'm a spellcaster. How about some Nord mead?
Yes, yes. Find myself a drink. Probably not, but it's worth a try. Good to see you. Hello, friend. Got any ale or mead?
If you're here for sightseeing, well, then you've seen the sights. Might as well head somewhere warm.
It's definitely cold in Winterhold. I think that's a safe bet.
If you're here for sightseeing, well, then you've seen the sights. Might as well head somewhere.
Nope, Berna's actually locked up Berna's oddments. Oh boy. To go into the frozen hearth.
What do you want,
yeah. Is there not a carriage around here? I might have to install a carriage mod, because there doesn't seem to be a carriage in Winterhold. That's fine. Wow, that is some snow. My god. That is a lot of snow. Oh, you'll see in a second since we're about to end the stream. Let me pop into the Jarl's Longhouse, which will probably be warmer. My god, that is a lot of snow.
What are we going to walk?
Hart. Kamen Rider Hart. Yeah, I'm not going to wake up the Jarl. That would be rude.
Well, there's something to remember when we watch the ghost movie.
Dragons breathing fire in the sky.
Very important.
Vampires lesson. Brazenly attacking people on the street.
Ghosts.
It's the end of the world, I tell you.
Alrighty, folks. So I will see you guys all next time. Peace out.
Ghost candy dinner.